axial versus equatorial substitution in cyclohexane. You've talked by now in class about the fact that larger substituents prefer to be in the equatorial position versus the axial position on a cyclohexane ring. And you probably talked about the fact that this has to do with the steric environment of the equatorial position compared to the axial position. What I want to do is look at how we can visualize why the equatorial position is favored for larger substituents. What I've done here is I've made two models of chair form cyclohexane. In one of them, I've put a generic larger substituent in the equatorial position. If you look, you can see the cyclohexane, and this is equatorial, this is axial. And in the other one, I've put the larger substituent in the axial position. And again, if we rotate this a little bit, you can see the cyclohexane ring, you can see our axial position, our equatorial position. There are two different ways we can visualize why having the larger position in the larger substituent in the equatorial position is better than the axial position, and I want to talk about both of them. First, we can think about it in terms of Newman projections, and what I want us to do is make a Newman projection or visualize a Newman projection between this carbon here in the front and this carbon in the back. So lined up just like that. And we're going to do the same thing in the other model where the larger group is in the axial position. So we're going to visualize a Newman projection with this carbon in the front and this carbon in the back, just like that. Now I want us to think about what groups are coming off the two carbons in our Newman projections. In the equatorial model, and I'm going to try to highlight these, so we've got this bond which is attached to the ring, this hydrogen, and this larger group on the front carbon, and on the back carbon I've got this hydrogen, this carbon attached to the rest of the ring, and this hydrogen. And I want to get rid of this pink cylinder or purple cylinder that it put around this, so I'm just going to click over here for a moment. But we can see the six positions coming off of our Newman projection. I'm going to do the same thing on the axial model. On the front carbon, I have the ring coming off of one of the positions, the hydrogen here, and my larger group. Oops. Ring, hydrogen, larger group on the front, and on the back I have one hydrogen, another hydrogen, and my ring. Now I want to think about these two Newman projections in terms of what the steric environment of this larger substituent is. And I want to start with the axial substituted cyclohexane, and we can see that in the axial substituted cyclohexane, in our Newman projection, the larger group is gauche to this ring, or the rest of the ring, I should say. So on the back carbon, we've got the rest of the ring coming off. And that is a sterically crowded situation. We know that gauche interactions are not as bad as eclipsed interactions, but they're not as good or low in energy as anti-interactions. On the other hand, if we look at our model where the larger substituent is equatorial, we can see that the larger substituent is anti to the rest of the ring coming off the back carbon. That is definitely a lower energy situation than what we have in the axial case where the larger substituent is in the gauche position. We can visualize these interactions in a different model if we want to. So this is a snapshot of the model from the previous screen where the larger group was equatorial. This is the snapshot where it's axial. And we can draw our Newman projection like this, where what I've done to simplify things is represented the rest of the ring other than my two carbons in my Newman projection as this curved line. And I did the same thing for the axial model. And what we can see for the axial model is that the larger group is gauche to the ring. On the other hand, if we look at the equatorial model, the larger group and the rest of the ring are anti to one another. This makes putting the larger group in the equatorial position lower in energy and thus the favorable conformation. The other way that we can talk about the stability of the equatorial substituent versus the axial substituent is in terms of how close it is to the other axial groups. What I've done here is I've colored all of my axial hydrogens in both models red so they stand out. And what you can see is that in the case of the axial substituent, it's actually quite close to the hydrogens on these other two axial positions. This is called 1-3 diaxial interactions because this, if we call this the one position, this hydrogen is 1-2-3 on the third carbon. So in the axial position, this substituent is quite close to the other axial positions. However, in the equatorial position, it's nowhere near the other axial hydrogens, or any axial hydrogens, and is thus less crowded. It's kind of sticking out into space far away from everything else. And that's another way we can rationalize why equatorial substituents are more stable in terms of having larger groups in the equatorial positions.